Mustafa al-Kadhimi has done what his two predecessors had failed to achieve, form a government. In a divided political sphere, getting parliament to approve a cabinet is not easy. The former intelligence chief got most of the ministers appointed, but failed to agree with other parties on the strategic oil ministry in foreign affairs. The challenges ahead are even more complicated.
My hope is that all political forces will join hands to face the difficult challenges ahead. Iraq's sovereignty, security, stability and prosperity are our path.
Iraq has already had its share of economic problems, and protests have rocked the country over the past year, in part due to poverty and unemployment. In recent weeks, that situation has further deteriorated, as oil prices have dropped. Oil sales account for almost 90% of Iraq's revenues. Like other countries around the world, the new government will have to tackle the coronavirus crisis. But one of the most challenging issues for Kadhimi comes from outside the country. It's the problem of Iran and the U.S. confronting each other in Iraq. Pro-Iranian militias have attacked U.S. targets there, and the U.S. killed top Iranian general Qasem Soleimani outside Baghdad airport. Iraq's parliament has voted to remove U.S. forces from the country. The U.S. will try to reverse that decision in talks with a new prime minister due in June. U.S. forces may prove useful to face another threat, the Islamic State group insurgency, which has reemerged. Okay, that right.